I'm Mitch Dupont with Abacor Benzel. Welcome. Today, we're diving into the future of welding and fabrication. And I'd like to introduce you to the iBOT One, a game changer in the industry. Like most industries, welding faces its challenges. The way some companies are trying to address these challenges is through cobot welding. This means numerous cobot welding manufacturers are vying for your attention. So why the iBOT One? The iBOT One stands out by prioritizing time efficiency, ultimately boosting your throughput and revenue. It's not just another cobot, it's a time-saving, profit-driving machine. You've seen cobot ads everywhere, right? Your success hinges on ease of use, and every ad you've seen makes the same claim. But we objectively measure ease of use. And how do we do this? We measure time. Time spent training, time spent programming, and the time it takes to get the arc on. Obviously, we want the least amount of time spent on these things. And obviously, this leads to increased profitability and efficiency. When you walk out on your plant floor and you see people banging parts into place, adjusting their smocks to stop arc burn or cleaning their nozzles to get proper gas coverage, this is all non-value added work. It's all necessary work and needs to be done to ensure a quality part and a comfortable work environment. But money is made when the arc is on. With the iBOT One, by measuring time, we're driving to reduce all non-value added actions, keeping your hands on the cobot and not pressing buttons on a teach pennant. This drives to arc on and making money, programming in just 15 minutes and you're welding within an hour. It's that simple. It enables small batch production while broadening your capabilities. So when you walk out on your shop floor and you look at your parts and you say, can I do that? Can I do those 5 parts, those 10 parts, those 1,000 parts? The answer has to be yes. So let's go over some of the hardware you will be getting in the programming of the system. Here's the cobot. There's 2 buttons on the flange. The recess button is for 0G off. The protruding button is for 0G on. We have this LED status light here. It'll become more apparent what this does when we get into the programming side, but this is a very important status light. If we rotate the torch around this way so you can see, we actually have a switch here that turns on a work light to illuminate your work surface. We have these 3 buttons for programming. M is for mode select, S is for save, and Z is for easy 0G. So if I press Z, you'll see that I can move the robot up very easily. I want to highlight the at-source fume extraction torch. The at-source fume extraction torch will extract the welding fume at the source, creating a much more pleasant environment for your worker. All right, so let's move on to the programming side now. All right, let's get into the programming. For this, I'm going to use my glasses because I'm an old man. I'm going to go through this at a moderate speed, representative of an experienced operator on your floor and how long they would take to put a simple weld in a program. All right, so we're going to start by going add product. We'll give it a product name. In this case, we'll call it demo. Okay, everything else on this screen is optional. We go next. In this case, we simply select torch, AF500. We pick a job number. In the job is all the welding parameters that we're using in the welder. I can turn weaving on, leave my amplitudes the same. If I slide up, I have my welding speed. Okay, so we'll leave that at 40 centimeters a minute. So we go next. I can now set the teach pennant down. I can create a whole program without ever touching the teach pennant again, keeping our hands off the teach pennant. So I'm going to switch 0G on. Now it's asking me to save my home position. And so if I hit the S button, that's going to save my home position. You can see the LED light blinks showing that it saved the position. So I know just by looking at my LED. If I hit my mode select button, I can go to yellow on my LED strip, and that tells me I'm in waypoint, non-welding. If I hit my light or my easy 0G, I can come down, store my waypoint, non-welding. You can see that it gets added in the software. The LED light matches the setting in the software for waypoint, yellow. I hit mode select. You can see the LED goes purple. It goes purple on the software. Welding linear. So I'm welding a straight line. I can come in, set my first position of the weld. I can come back, set my end position of the weld. I hit my mode button again to go yellow on my ring, yellow on my software, back out, hit save, and I'm done. So now I'll pick up the teach pennant again. And so That took me 25, maybe 30 seconds, and I talked my way through it. If I didn't talk my way through it, I could have done that in 10 or 15 seconds. So if you have a part that has 5 or 6 welds in it, there's no reason that that part can't be programmed necessarily in 2 to 5 minutes. All right? And then you can be into production. So once we're done, we simply hit save, which I don't have to come here and change any of the parameters because we did, that's why we set them all in the beginning. I hit save, I go production list. Now, what is run in auto when we hit the button over there, which you'll see in a minute, is what is actually run is the work order. And you can put as many programs that you've created in the work order. And when you hit play, it runs the programs. So I simply select the program I just made demo. I say add to work order. It moves it over to the work order. In this case, I want to test it to make sure what I did was good. So I'm going to turn dry weld on. And now I can set my teach pennant down. Since it's not going to weld, I can just leave it right there. It's not going to get damaged. I can flip my switch to auto and I can hit the start button and the program is now going to run, making my parts. So you can see by simply turning weave on, we actually have a weave in the weld. So I appreciate you taking the time to watch this video. Hopefully you've seen something that intrigues you. And if you want any more information on the iBOT, please reach out to your Abacore Benzel salesperson, distributor, or any links in this video or online on the website, you can find it. All right, so let's weld. We can pick up the teach pennant. I'll turn dry weld off. I simply have to hit start again.